I'm Stephen Bendanuni. You're watching Israeli News Live. The airstrikes that were done just the other day by Israel on Syrian targets at the Syrian National Airport, International Airport, that is, and also in, which was in Damascus, and also Damas, which is also a military area for the Syrian government there, has been confirmed by the Israeli government that yes, indeed, they did carry out the airstrikes. According to Israel's government, they were actually targeting S-300 missile systems that are used in they were bound for Hezbollah to be used there in Lebanon. These are air batteries designed by Russia to be able to thwart incoming air attack on any nation that they may have these air systems in, much like the Iron Dome that Israel uses. Only lets you know that Lebanon, with Hezbollah there in Lebanon, they are preparing for war with Israel, one that no doubt is soon at hand. Also, in the Catholic news, notice here on December the 5th, they published an article in the Catholic News Service here where the Christians and Muslim leaders vowed to walk hand in hand to promote peace. Interesting. Muslim leaders are attacking Israel left and right, and yet the Vatican walks hand in hand, and of course so do the Christian leaders, walking hand in hand with the Vatican, promoting their version of peace there. They stated here in the Catholic website, the Catholic, Sunni, and Shiite delegations at the summit each included one woman scholar. The Anglican delegation included two women clergy and two female scholars. Enough is enough. We are brothers in Abraham, they said. We speak different languages. We live in different parts of the world, but Christianity and Islam both teach that humanity is one family, and religious leaders have an obligation to resist attempts to divide brothers and sisters with violence. This was said by the Episcopal Bishop John Bryson, the Chain of Washington. Bishop Chain spoke December 4th at the final public session of the summit, which concluded with a call to action that also included pledges to travel together to areas affected by severe violence as a sign their followers that Christianity and Islam are religions of peace, to focus more attention on equipping young people to live with respect for other faiths and promote collaboration among Catholic, Anglican, and Muslim aid agencies. The declaration was signed by Bishop Chain, Cardinal Jean Louis Turan, President of Pontifical Council for the Interreligious Dialogue, Prince El Hassan bin Talal of Jordan, and Ayatollah Siad Mustafa Mohaghigha Damad of Iran. Interesting to see how the one world religion is coming together that will also affect a one world order. Now, a little bit of news that actually is old. It was published on Israel Today about a little over a year ago. It was an article that was brought to my attention today. Israeli minister will have to uproot thousands of Jews. I wanted to bring this to you mainly because we're about to see the fulfillment of something that was said in a interview by Mr. Lapid, the finance minister of Israel. He said Israel must come to terms with the fact that it will have to uproot thousands of Jews from their homes and to facilitate the creation of a Palestinian Arab state. We need to have a final map, said Lapid. We cannot escape the need to map the final borders of a future Palestinian state, including an organized plan for the evacuations of tens of thousands of Jews. Settlers is what he called them, but they're actually Jewish people. At the same time, Lapid said Israel needs to know that acceptable security arrangements will be made to bring an end of ongoing Palestinian terrorism. Well, that seems to be the answer. And what's interesting, though, he said the Palestinian terrorism. Well, it was almost as if he was forecasting what the Palestinians were planning on doing to bring about this two-state solution. It's exactly what we've been seeing in the last months here, a Palestinian terrorism uprise, a third intifada. Well, I was reminded, though, when I thought of this article here and then seeing the fulfillment and about to be in process here of Micah's prophecy of chapter 4. Well, chapter 4 and verse 10. Be in pain and labor to bring forth, O daughter of Zion. like a woman in travail, for now shalt thou go forth out of the city, and thou shalt dwell in the field. And thou shalt go even to Babylon, and there shalt thou be delivered. There the Lord shall redeem thee from the hand of thine enemies. Well, Babylon is Rome. And yes, that's exactly where Israel has gone in order to broker some kind of peace agreement. But the very place that she's gone, Israel's enemy, is where God will deliver her from. That's very soon at hand. I'm Stephen Bentinum, Israeli News Live. Good evening.